We're letting Kovac go.
We're getting rid of Kovac?
We're not here to make friends. I want you to tell him.
What?
Being asked to cut somebody is not something that comes easily for Charles. He doesn't think he has that cutthroat gene.
What you want to talk to me about again?
Logically, you would think, yeah, he'd be excited to get rid of the guy that they cut him for. But his heart is just too big. And his wife, who's always there to support him and love him, helps him to realize, hey, this is part of the job.
This is not your decision. Just like it wasn't your decision when they decided to cut your ass. If you don't tell him, Seifert will.
Turn the car around.
What Julie is telling him is that you can do it with some empathy and you can do it with some sensitivity that maybe the organizations aren't able to have.
You're young and you're gonna land somewhere that really needs you. And you're gonna play in this league for a long ass time. You gotta trust me. I've been around long enough to know.
By nature, he's a competitor. There's a lovable exterior and he's a really nice guy, but when he learns this game of the front office, he's gonna be a monster. He's gonna be a beast.
Spencer is just a pretty facade. You are the mechanism that moves that machine. Come work for me.
Andre represents the ultimate power. He's the devil. And like the devil, will come in smiling and want to be your best friend.
I've been thinking about your offer, and I'm going to have to respectfully decline.
When he doesn't get what he wants, I think that's kind of surprising to Andre. I think he thought he was going to be able to do what he wanted to do, which was to get Joe to leave. And when he doesn't, he knows there's tension there, and he gives him a little bit more suspicion on Spencer.
Your partner lost quite a bit of money a while back.
He's planting the seeds to destroying that relationship between Joe and Spencer.
If Spencer doesn't trust you enough to tell you the truth about his past, how could you possibly trust him with your future?
Boy, something to think about, huh? For the drive home.
Yeah.
Great, thank you. Gotta go.
This is Travis Mack.
Travis, it's a pleasure to meet you. Heard a lot about you.
Anything good?
Yeah, Spencer said a few nice things.
Why are you shitting all over me, man?
Travis?
No, seriously, I read all the articles and stuff, right? And do you really think I have small hands? I mean, look, does this hand look small to you? Take a look at that one.
Spence.
Maybe this isn't such a good idea.
Mark Schlereth is not a believer in Travis Mack. He's seen enough head cases that he doesn't believe that this guy has the stuff.
What are you doing?
What are you doing? You're gonna sabotage this whole thing before we even push off?
Spencer sees a lot of himself in Travis Mack. Here's this kid who's incredibly talented, physically gifted, athletically gifted, blessed. And then he's incredibly underdeveloped with his social skills and with his ability to make good decisions, like a few of us were in college.
You know what? We're gonna hit reset right now and just get to know each other. You're both players.
No. He's a has-been.
Travis just doesn't know how to play nice. He disagrees with Mark's opinion, and he's not afraid to tell him. He doesn't want to be a fraud. He doesn't want to be a fake. And I think that Mark ultimately sees that and appreciates it. And Travis shows him something from an athletic standpoint by running that great time in the 40-yard dash on the beach.
4, 5, 8.
Wow!
At the end of the day, they achieve what they wanted to achieve. Now the question is whether or not that's going to have any profound impact on where he goes in the draft.